Hello everyone, my name is Nathan, and today it's time for another episode of Cities Skylines. In between the episode, I developed this part a little bit. I let the houses upgrade, I let the traffic calm down, I regulated the bus lines, etc, etc. Planted a couple of trees. We are still making around 8,000 plus a week, and we are at 7 million funds at the moment. So everything is all right. There are just a couple of issues. For instance, this thing here is full. Let's empty this, and then what problems do we have here? Citizens are sick. Yeah, I did notice a couple of issues with my services. The problem is not that I don't have enough services. The problem is that the services are going to different districts where they are not supposed to. There's actually one thing I want to check out. For instance, policies. What types of policies do we have? Less power usage, recycling, free public transport. I'm not that desperate. Oh, prisons. We don't have any prisons at the moment. That would be a cool thing to do. But nothing really I want to implement right now. Let's actually check out the prison. How does that look like? Prison, and that would be the police headquarters. So it's not that large, but we probably want to have this secluded somewhere. So maybe we think about the permanent location of this track here. And we could make this a bigger train station. Let's actually see what types of stations we have. Multi-platform end. We don't want an end. I might have to download more from the workshop. Doesn't look like we have lots of possibilities. We either go with this one or with a really large one with multiple tracks. Oh, jeez. I did not mean to do that. Oh my gosh. Do I get my funds back? Yes, okay. Thank God for the mods. This train station right here would be used by the Old Town and the Olive District. At the moment, I have bus lines going from here to there and there, so people can easily use them. I actually have also a ton of people using the subways. Look at that. There is an enormous amount of people here. I cannot even supply them all, even with the budget increased to the maximum. This actually also resulted in a couple of issues. You can see my wagons are right here and they actually have to wait in line because so many wagons are going to the Old Town. One solution to that problem would be to set up yet another subway, maybe around here, and then just leave this over there. They're still gonna intersect, but it might be better. Oh, another thing I did is actually change this intersection here. I had to make it somewhat more fluent. So at the moment, people from here go actually into a tunnel and they come out all the way, let me see, right here. People that want to go to the other side from here, they can actually simply use this tunnel and go through there. Let me actually check out a train here. We have a space for 240 passengers. Yeah, I think I'm gonna end up having a normal station here, and then we somehow lead the train tracks through here as well and have a station there. Copper Square actually also has tons of people, 5,000. So that might be well worth it. I'm gonna build it in a way so that I can still expand the train station into a bigger one, but for the time being we need to remove this. We want to make this a really nice setting for our train station. So I think the first thing I'm gonna do is adjust this road a little bit. I want to make this nicer. How about something like that? This would also give us a little bit more space to build. Maybe we can have a park right here. That would actually be great. Yes, I like that. We will have to fix some of the bus lines. At the moment, of course, they do not make any sense. Holy cow, where is this bus line even going? Oh man, it has been changed insanely. So maybe let's get rid of that. Train station to Olive District. We need to remove that and we will add another one. Same thing with train station to Old Town. That's not gonna work. Okay, let me go ahead and rearrange everything just a tiny little bit and I'm gonna be right back once we know how this is gonna look. Alright, I am back and I developed the area a little bit. The first thing I did is I laid a track that is actually passing the train station. So for all of the trains that are going somewhere else, I also connected this line right here to the train track pre-placed by the map. So right now we still have a similar setup. Actually, this junction here is gonna be an issue because I still need to bring the train tracks over here and of course I also need to connect it right there. So let's see if we can do this in a reasonable manner. Of course, we want to have smooth curves, so the trains don't really have to slow down. How about that? Is that smooth enough? Yeah, that looks smooth. Okay, how does it look though? That's gonna be alright once we, you know, decorate it and everything. But right here I will still have to do something else. This, by the way, is going to be an office area. We have a little bit of industrial demand, so I think that's a good idea. Now, do we want to go above or below? I could, of course, go just straight through here and connect with the track right there. I mean, right now this isn't the most beautiful thing. I will still have to fix a couple of things. But yeah, that is going to be a little bit of detail work, apparently. Okay, there we go. That already looks a little bit better. We shall see how it looks once we decorate it. But for now, all I want is to go up here, over the street, and unfortunately I'm a little bit too close here. Can we connect this up like so? Yeah. I don't like that. What if we did something like that? That is much better and more subtle. I like that. Now we only have to go over here and finally curve into our already existing track, which is not possible at this angle. Come on. Oh no, that's not good. We have to fix that using move it. Oh, actually we can fix everything. Totally forgot about that. Yes, okay, that's what I'm talking about. Going smoothly along the roads, we can also see all of the tracks, there's no more clipping. Yes, I definitely approve of that. By the way, I actually already reached the 44,000 milestone. I did have a death wave, it was actually horrible. A lot of the citizens died. But yeah, now they are all right and well again, so who cares. Let me redo this area here. I want this street to be connected. Why don't we just do something like that and then maybe have a normal street connecting to this area here as well. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. So we have offices all around here, maybe a little bit of residential, and then this slope right here is totally not necessary. We're gonna do something like that. Does that... Ooh, that looks a little crazy, I have to admit. I'm not gonna do that. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go beneath here, probably. Something like that. And that looks a little less crazy. However, there's a slight issue. I don't want people to go from here all the way through there. They should take the highway up to this point. So we cannot have this connection here. Maybe we're just gonna connect it right here, to be honest with you. Okay, that seems to be reasonable enough for the time being. Let's actually create another bus line. Let me see, that's not buses right there. And we basically want a way to get to my old town district. And I think I just did it right here, didn't I? And if I go back, well, then we have to take an enormous route. So maybe I actually went through here. Add another stop right there. Add one more stop right here. And I guess now we can go back, right? Oh no, I thought I could turn around here. These streets drive me insane sometimes. So maybe we make another stop, then right there, there, and come back. Then we're gonna need yet another line that is going to the Copper Square. No, Olive District, it's called. Actually, let me start this one over here. That makes more sense. And then we go right there. We go somewhat close to the subway here. Though I already have lines going there. Oh man, I lost overview of the lines once again. It's the third time I'm redoing them, basically. The blue bus line here is actually quite busy, so I think it doesn't hurt if I add a couple more stops where we have the blue lines. So we could, for instance, add a stop right there, add another stop right here, and kind of do the turn. And then we can come back right there, right here, and let me see, probably right there, and finish the line. Great. We take that for the time being. Let's unpause the game and see how things are developing. Yeah, these people now have no bus to go to. And more buses are shipping out. 223 at the moment in use. No electricity. Oh, that's bad. Electricity comes from here. Oh, it's gonna reach it anyways once the offices are in. Yes, okay, okay, okay. This might work. Take the power. Okay, thankfully that didn't end in a complete disaster. And we have tons of people waiting here. So we will probably have to increase this bus line's buses. Let me actually see. Line details, 173. We only have 5 buses in use here, but they're just accumulating right now. So we need to observe it a little bit, let it run. In the meantime, we start building a couple of offices. These are going to be normal office buildings. I want to fill up this one first and this one next. And that hopefully is also going to give us the necessary power. Now for a couple of residentials, we're just going to do low density. Maybe right there could be good. Oh, holy cow. So many holes. And then I also would like to do this and that. Good. Time to speed things up a little bit. Every time I redo the boss lines, I need to let a couple of weeks pass, so we can actually see the effects. Oh, another thing I totally forgot about is the water. Now, looking at my buildings here, a ton still need upgrading, for instance these guys. Yeah, they're not quite upgraded, so it wouldn't hurt to also place down a park right here. Let's see, I want to have something foresty, maybe something a little bit bigger. Come on, where are the big ones? Right there. Okay, we're gonna add that guy against this street here, which is not too busy. And this is gonna increase the worth a lot. Actually, we have tons of problems here with the worth, it seems. So let's add more of that stuff. Why the heck not? I want people to upgrade, but maybe not too quickly. It does end in a disaster sometimes. We could set up another park right there. We shall do that. And maybe one for you guys. Let me grab another one. This one. People are sick again. I'm sick of sick people. Let's place it here. Good. We need to eradicate a couple of buildings. I decided not to go with the automatic bulldoze mod. Feels like I deserve the punishment if I don't manage my city well, then a lot of buildings are being abandoned. For instance, right now, these guys also have issues. What is your problem? Not enough goods to sell, so the industry is lame or the traffic isn't getting there. Now, these cars. Maybe that street wasn't the best of ideas. I thought this would solve a lot of issues because we have bus lines, but the cars are going crazy here. Man, and all these garbage trucks that don't belong here. Maybe we can simply not have a connection here, I don't know. This is just confusing everyone here. What we could do though is make this a one-way street, so people can at least access the train station. Let's actually try that. This is gonna be one way right there, but we want to change it. Something like that, and now people will be forced to go somewhere else. And these guys will actually use the correct highway. Yeah, traffic is basically the only difficulty in this game. And of course to, you know, make things beautiful. It's easy to make a grid city, but it's not quite as fun. Oh, it's burning. Oh, actually, do we have all the services here? We could use a little bit of healthcare. It would make more sense right here. But these round streets, you can place anything. I think I'm gonna have another hospital right here or a clinic. Let's also see a crematorium. We probably could use one more right next to it. We check out the fire. Fire is good coverage. Police. Let's see. Ah, we still don't have the prison. Maybe we are gonna add a prison here. Could be a nice tourist attraction. Let's see. What if we branched off from here a little bit and we place the prison right here for the time being. And we shall see, you know, what else we build in this place. So prison, you go right there. And now we can actually take care of the criminals. Right now, everyone got off scot-free, basically. Or maybe they got shipped out to another city. Ah, I love copper gardens. It's actually also quite worth it. I'm making money from this. I don't make money from my other park right here. And by the way, I also placed this ride, the roller coaster. What is it called? Hyper Gate. Oh, it's so fun. But I don't think this park is making me money. Yeah, I do have 700 more expenses than income. But that's quite alright, we might be able to change a few things still and improve on that. Okay, slowly but surely the traffic is relieving a little bit. Now we have too many cars going in from here. I just don't understand why you guys want to do that. Oh, actually my bus lines are screwed, aren't they? Because I did that. Driving me insane! Okay, there we go. I think I fixed it. Now we need to somehow prevent people from actually going through here. Holy cow, look at all the freaking people we have here. Oh no. Okay, I'm actually gonna delete this bus line again. We are doing it differently. We're doing it, as I said, upgrade this to a one-way street, and then this connection is fine. We want people to stay on the highway to get into the Olive District. And that essentially means we need our bus to go right over here, take the long way. Yeah, there we go. That's what I wanted to see. Let's actually give this a different color. This is kind of confusing. Also, this is train station to Olive District. And then this bus line, which is gonna be yellow, it's gonna be train station to Old Town. There we go. 7 stops, but we probably need more buses for that. My prison still has no access to water or power. Poor guys. Wow. Criminals in prison. Immediately 12. Filling up quite quickly. Now, let's see. We have 30 buses in use here. That's not the line I wanted to check out. This one here I want to check out. We have tons and tons of passengers. I'm gonna raise this to 12 buses already. Oh my gosh, this is the most horrible thing I've ever done. Yeah, they're waiting for the blue line. Everyone is waiting for the blue line. But I cannot have any more buses. The traffic is really crappy here. We have 4,200 people using mass transit every week, and it would be more if I could accommodate them all. All of these buses are full. This one is even coming in full. Yeah, we should probably distribute the lines a little bit differently. But that is something I'm just gonna play around every now and then while watching a movie or so. Oh, it's burning! Nah, someone is taking care of it. Good job, guys, good job. We have 76 prisoners. I wonder if these are really citizens and they are, you know... Yeah, look at that. Resides at the Dean residence. So normally he is right here, but right now he is in prison. Oh, I love that. Just feels so much more realistic when everyone is an actual citizen with a job, with a home, and not just props, you know. You know, another problem is that the buses are just waiting for such a long time. I mean, they're waiting for like 2 days or even longer. It's insane. They are even waiting when they already have 30 passengers. So on the other side, my monorails are being used more often, I think. No, just 18 here. Yeah, I'm not a too big fan of the monorails, at least not in the way I set it up. I think, you know, it might be better if you have a long straight street from one end to the other. This could be good for monorails. Also, maybe if I reduce the amount of buses that I have, the amount of bus lines, then they might be using them more effectively. But at the moment, we just have... is this the monorail? No, actually, right here. 88 per week! What the heck? I once was at 300 or 400, I think. How are we doing with the blue passengers? Okay, we are actually slowly but surely getting it under control. It's always a disaster when I change some of the bus lines. But we did it, and we are growing once again above 40,000. Looks as though a lot of my shops are being abandoned because we cannot deliver the goods. So actually, maybe we do need a cargo station here as well. Anyways, time to make this a little bit nicer using trees and bushes. How about that? Already much better. I want to fill this area up with bigger trees, actually. I think, yeah, some of those. Helps a little bit with noise pollution. Beautiful. Oh man, I just love how everything adds up in the end. I like this area a lot more now than when I started the episode. It looks as though we need a lot of industry, but I don't really believe them. Why did you abandon them? Building because no one was buying their products. Oh, okay, so that is another problem. So maybe it's time to add yet another district. I will have to switch up this highway, fit it for my needs. We could also be doing much better in terms of parks. I just feel like these guys need to be upgraded a little bit more. Why not add another botanical garden? Or do we already have that in this district? I don't think so. So the botanical garden is actually quite a long reach. But we need a place where we can add it, maybe right here in the corner. Yes, that did do something for sure. Another incentive to upgrade. Maybe a carousel? Come on, where can I fit this in without destroying everything? I can fit it in here. Yeah, and that basically did the rest for us. Man, we have almost no uneducated citizens. This is a problem. We might want to make a district with the policy that they prefer the industrial work over something that requires education. What about my trains here? We have plenty of trains. Do we have more passengers? Yes, a little bit more. Good, so I guess to complete this a little bit, we ought to make another train station somewhere around here. Now, these guys are doing fine, I think. I'm just gonna leave this in. This is also gonna be changed into something more beautiful. But for now, I would like this train track to also kind of wiggle around here somehow. Okay, there we go. This is not my final placement, but for now it will suffice so we can already place the train station. All we have to do is make a little something right here. I'm gonna make this street and then I guess we're gonna have our usual loop. Something like that. What about bus stops right here? I don't think we have any. Do we have? Well, we have one here, but that isn't quite close enough. So maybe we drag another stop to over there. And yet one more stop right here. Good. Let's build our train station at this point and hook up the tracks. There we go. Beautiful. Do we want to hook this up with this one? I think I want to do that, even though it might be only temporary. One goes right there and the other one goes... come on. So now trains can also come in from both directions, actually. They don't have to go through the entire loop. Let's not forget about the services. And do we have the power? Yes, we do. Okay, did I destroy any power lines? I don't think so, but this is now connected, so we can save on the maintenance for this shebang. Oh, you actually have the option to only allow trains from your own city. That's intriguing. That might help with planning of the mass transit. My buses are doing much better. However, the metro. Metro is crazy. Let's actually check out the lines right here. We have 1,000 passengers. But this doesn't actually look too bad. It looks quite fluent because we are picking up tons of people here. It's just that they are accumulating so quickly. But overall, I feel like we can be happy. What types of industries can we actually still do? Commercial specialization. A leisure specialization might actually be nice. But we still have oil. We don't have a generic industry at the moment, so this might be interesting too, because the generic industry can be upgraded, contrary to the specializations. So I'm actually thinking about making a nice normal generic industry right here with a really nice way to get people on and off. They could simply go through here to get on and then they do their thing and they're being led to this highway to get off again. I think that's exactly what I'm gonna end up doing. So maybe we are starting with large roads here. I want to have a nice one. And let me think, we probably want to take a little turn here up to maybe this point. And then we go all the way up to there. So this is gonna be a very large industry. Or we actually do this with the highway. Because I can have much better intersections with the highway. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do something like that, and then we upgrade it to highways. This might not be the smartest of ideas to have such corners, but I want to plan out the district first, and then we shall see what happens. Let's go with large six-lane roads, or can we actually do the normal ones? Nah, I'm tempted to use the large ones, one way. So we could, for instance, start right here. This could be our first line, and yeah, it is one way. The next one would come right there, and so on and so forth. I'm kind of tempted to do it like that. I wanted to do like fancy on and off ramps. Well, we could do the fancy on and off ramps still, just to make it look a little bit better. Let's actually see how large we want to make this. Maybe one more after this. We could fit one more in here. I think that's gonna be good. Yes, I like that. Let's also switch this up a little bit. I think I want to increase the level of it. So we go up approximately right there. There we go. And now we might be able to make fancy off-ramps. Actually, we could do this with highways, right? Let me think about that. I might have to build it the other way around. Something like that. Holy cow. No. It's not really doing it smoothly with the slope, right? It's doing the slope in the last possible moment. So maybe we can still do it from here, but we do something like that and then connect this. Yeah, that looks much better. So probably something like that is what I'm gonna end up doing. I don't really like what it's doing with the bridge, but we can adjust that with the move it tool. We can align the height. Yeah, let me quickly finish this and I'm gonna be right back. Okay, I couldn't really make it nice enough, so I decided to go with the six-lane roads still. But now it's actually time to align these guys. What we want is we want to grab all of these junctions here. With shift-click, you can add more of them. Then we click this align heights button and we click on this node. Oh my gosh. Okay, let's do it differently. I'm gonna grab this align heights with you. I'm gonna grab this align heights with you. Ah, okay, so I see. We didn't grab all of them, of course. That's why it didn't work. For instance, this guy right here. Yeah, look at that. That looks much smoother, much better. Now, of course, this crazy thing right here. I cannot use that. Good. I didn't take care of my city for a while, but there are astonishingly few abandoned buildings. Just the two right here. So the city isn't flourishing too badly at the moment. All right, time for some generic industry. Let me actually just paint this. For the time being, I think I'm just gonna connect it like so. And of course, we should also have a way for people to get into the other direction, to be honest with you. We should also have a way for people from this side. Oh, actually, they do. They can just go over the bridge. To achieve that, all we have to do basically is go down here, take a little curve somewhere along these lines, and then we go up right there. And all we have to do now is connect all of these streets to the same tunnel. We can do it right there, I guess. Yeah, beautiful. I'll be right back once we've done it for all of them. Okay, that is actually not too bad, I have to say. I'm almost happy with the results. And people now have a way to get out of this district. Amazing! Let's give it some supplies, water and power. And after that, I guess it's time to zone. I'm gonna do my first zoning right here. And of course, after that, we also need some services. And they need to be on a street that can access everything. So I thought maybe services can have their own little streets beneath here. I'm not sure I can actually do... Yes, look at that. I can totally do that. But it's not going to be very easy, for instance, right here. We might have to move this just a little bit. The pillar out of the way. Ah yeah, of course. Right here it's getting too low. There's no way we can actually make it through here. Good, then I give up on this idea and we're just gonna have the street on the other side of the pillars. And we do something like that. And now we can hook up all of the streets, just like that. And of course there's a pillar in the way every time. Oh, actually we can totally do it in a nice manner, such as this. Good, let's do two of these clusters. One more right there and we actually get rid of this little thing. Good, that means we can have services, and we need that for the industry to upgrade, of course. So we're gonna have a clinic, we're gonna have a cemetery, though we probably don't need that. Let's add one of those. Let's also add a fire station, we're gonna add a police station right there. And we don't need schools or anything like that, but we will need maybe public transport, just to, you know, make them upgrade. But I'm gonna wait with that. Let's unpause the game and see if everything is hooked up correctly and whether or not they are actually starting to build. Cherry Heights. Nice. Let's call this Cherry Industries. And they're already starting to build. And if we click this, we can see they actually have three stages. So we definitely want to upgrade them because the higher level the building, the more educated workers it requires. Alright, nice. That's coming along. It lowered our industrial demand by a lot, but I'm not gonna zone anymore until we require it again. And of course, that also allows us to add more residential soon and hopefully reach the next milestone. Today wasn't very milestone heavy, I know, but we cannot just mindlessly grow our city without taking care of the individual districts first. Cool. So I think at this point I'm going to wrap it up for today's episode. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a great time and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.